Hello and welcome to the latest edition of the SWN Podcast. I am your host, as always, Billy, looking so much whiter than usual because I've spent the weekend being ill. I am joined on this episode by a returning guest for the first time. This is episode 200 and something, 30 something. And way back on April 1st, 2022, was the last time we had a full chat with this man. It is now the greatest 20-year-old wrestler of all time. It's Ronan King. Welcome back.
Thank you very much for having me, Billy.
I'm excited to have you back on because last time, I say 130, episode 136 was the last time I had you on. April 1st, 2022 was the release date. And at that point, you'd only debuted like the year before, end of the year, which was December, Christmas Chaos, I think it was. And you packed in a lot in that, what, 5 months, 4 months, probably, since we recorded it. And then since then, you've packed in a lot more. So we're going to try to condense that. So we're not just, I'm not got you for the whole afternoon and we're just going through every intricate detail of your life when it comes to wrestling. But how's it going?
Oh, there's a lot. What's up?
How's it going?
Great, it's great. I feel good. How are you doing?
Like I said, I've felt better, but it's okay. The lighting makes me look whiter than I really am. Although I'm really, really white. But we're just going to go. We've got questions about tans. We've got questions about tans coming up. So we'll start kind of from last time we properly spoke. So that was just before Aberdeen Anarchy, would have been the month before, ish. You were embroiled in a feud with Mickey Vago. And
Fuck that guy.
And it came to a head at Aberdeen Anarchy in was it Mosh Pit Match at that point?
Anarchy was the Singapore King.
Singapore King. That was
the Nations we went to Mosh Pit.
Right, I missed that one, so that was...
Great match.
I know. Did you hit anyone in the crowd with that one, or was that just, that was a fairly
safe... You know
safe
what? There's a moment at the start, what did I hit him with? I hit him with a drum, and I let go, and it springs out, and it's like, you see my eyes just watching, like, oh my god, it's about to happen again, it's good. It just stopped in the front row, so... Oh. It was going at Kyle though, so it'd be fine if I met him. Fuck that guy.
he would appreciate it. But yeah, that would have been one of the first couple of times I've seen you wrestle, and you did the guitar swing for Vago, threw it back behind you, and yeah, it hit someone in the crowd. I've got an amazing compo face picture of it. It's just incredible. Couldn't have timed it any better.
She deserved it. I'll stand there right now and say she deserved it. So no regrets.
Is that kind of attitude you got to have at that stage of your career, or with that confident character that Ronan King is? Because that's who Ronan King is. That's who you are. You've just got to just roll with it. Is there any moment where you thought, "Oh no, this was a bad...
That guitar was one.
Right,
that guitar was one. swearing. Okay. I thought I was gonna be hungry from every single show ever. I was like, right, that's it. I'm done. I'm going to get kicked off everything, so luckily got away with that. I'm trying to think of other ones. There's been a few that have been like, ooh, was that too far? But no, seemed to get the good reaction that I want, so, you know.
And Kelly still has a little bit of a beef with you for noting that you winning the Speed title would look better than her son, my son. And she still has a little, she's like, if he wasn't so good, I'd really hate him. But
I stand by it. Sorry, Billy. I stand by it. I would look really good with that belt.
But it makes me laugh every time I speak about you. She's like, if he wasn't so goddamn talented, I would really, really hate him. It's like, yeah, but for that, when you go to a show, you boo him, you get the reaction he wants. But he is, yeah, but still, that was the only time you said a line for her. And I mean, I've seen you hit people with guitars, so. You know, you got to. Oh, we'll see you stab a guy. We'll get into that. Right.
Yeah,
anyway.
That's another one.
So, yeah, so that's where we're kind of there. Aberdeen Anarchy time, Bago. How did you find that kind of over that whole feud for you? Was that just got you off, shot you off? Know what the words are. I can't remember any words at this moment in time. So I got you off on the ground running. Big feud. Bago was very popular coming back from the restart of shows. So it was important to you to make an impression to the crowd every time you went out there.
100%. And Like, give Vega his flowers because that was the perfect feud for me to start with because he is such a strong character and he's so good at what he does in the ring. I couldn't have thought of a better first feud to bring me in. And it was so much fun. I remember my eyes lighting up when I got told you're going to go to like weapons matches and stuff. I was like, yeah, this is going to be so much fun. So, like, looking back on that feud to this day, I'm still like, yeah, I love that feud. I'll go grab it. I've actually got this in my living room in my G flat. Ooh. I've still got from the mosh pit.
Oh, nice.
I don't know how I gained it, but I was moving out and I was like, oh, yeah, I want that. So grabbed it.
Vago has a problem with leaving stuff hanging around because I've still got the sign that he had at Summerhill Showdown, which banned me from the venue. I took that home afterwards and I've still got it. Because
Okay,
you
that's
know that's a fantastic little bit of memorabilia. But like you're saying, that's a big thing to do though in that first 6 months is you're going from just debuting, making that much of an impression, you're getting put into these kind of big matches, marquee matches on shows, as well, with someone like Vago, who's absolute opposite to you.
Yeah.
You're the I would say more bubblegum as in as form as your appearance, more brightly colored and all that kind of stuff. And then you got Vago, who's the rock guy, the metal guy, all, and it's just chalk and cheese that respect. But in the ring, it's just work out perfectly.
It worked, you know what I mean? Like, and that was the whole thing. We're so different, but when we came together, it was so much fun. It was so easy, you know what I mean? Like, he's so great, and he was really useful getting me through those first few months. So big flowers to Vago for that.
There you go. So for Vago for trying to ban me and cancel me at shows, there we go. We've put him over for the first
Sorry,
couple
Joey. Fuck Vago, piece of
months.
shit.
So from that point onwards, we were looking at just you're one of the guys you had to see on a show, which I'm not. This is going to be about an hour of me just going, you're great, because unfortunately you are. But
I
there was a
appreciate that. Thank you.
there's a moment in between the match we're going to speak about, or I'm going to touch on next, is the tweet. We're just going to just jump into the tweet, the tweet that haunts you for life. The response to Kyle and Kayleigh in their podcast. It was a caption contest of some description, and you put out the tweet. Was it Ronan King is not the greatest wrestler of all time? And this seems
Biggest
to
regret of my life.
that's now that's top. That one, swearing. Hitting the woman with the pillow.
Yeah.
That's
That one
top.
hurts the most because it actually affects me.
But so it's that's still, I don't know how you really think about it, because it's still engagement, I suppose, at the end of the day, isn't it? It's still, people are still interacting with you and knowing it's riling you up, at least on social media, at the very least. Have you thought about putting on a t-shirt?
Someone else can put on a t-shirt. Billy, you put on a t-shirt. I'm not gonna put it. There you go. Steal that.
I'm having that.
I know. Lightning Lariat puts it up at every show. Morgan loves it because it's a great reaction. Ronan hates it. I'm like, oh, this again. I've got to deal with it now. I thought about just drop kicking the iPad personally. You know, just out the building.
I do quite enjoy, like, the first time I saw him try to do it, he doesn't like lock his orientation. So he kept trying to turn it just for you to see it, and he kept turning away. It's like you couldn't see it. But oh man, yeah. But that's it. Everyone listening, Ronan King says I could put on a t-shirt. I'm putting on a t-shirt. There you go. That's Christmas. Christmas sorted. New
Christmas
year.
out.
That's it.
I'll buy one. I'll buy one.
it's just amazing though. Like at that point, well, you're 18 at that point. Then was it? No, you were 19.
Yeah, we've been 18 for
Yeah.
that tweet. Yeah.
And we've talked about it before, probably in the first episode we did about confidence and all that. But being able to get the fans to gravitate to you so quickly in that time, in that short period of time, that must just be like confidence overblown.
Yeah.
How do you kind of humble yourself sometimes when you look back on it and go, right, okay, but I still got this I can do. I can still do this. I can still improve here or there, even though I've got the crowd doing what I want them to do.
I think I'm very fortunate with the people I surround myself around. And we'll get into this more later, but like the Wrestling Training Academy, Emersyn, Aspen, Judas, even like all of my like close friends, Skinner, everyone, they keep me humble in the best way possible. Like, I like to keep myself humble. I'm so hard on myself after every match because I want to know what's better, but I credit that to my training. Is up at wrestling, it's great because it's always, that was good, but what can we do to make it better? And that's the way I like to live. So, like, after every match, I could be the happiest man in the world of that match, but instantly looking at what can I do better next time. And I think that's the best way to wrestle, because you don't want to ever cap. You always want to just, I hate when I come back and they're like, yeah, that was good. It's like, okay, but so people keeping telling me how to get better and better is the best way, and it keeps me humble in the best way as well.
That seems to be the key thing I'm hearing when I'm doing these interviews, is that there has to be a but. If anyone's giving you any feedback, there has to be that there. You can go onto our site and we'll give you all the praise in that. But the people that are actually there know what they're doing, is that's the bit that you need to I suppose keep an eye on and ear on and what have you. But speaking of that, then Grado, Halloween Night Thanks 2022. You came out as an angel to take on Grado, which I'll be perfectly honest with you, this is a match I was on that show, of course, with Dynamite and Aspen, which was going to be nuts anyway, which it was. But this is the match when I saw it, I was going, oh yes, this is going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah,
Grado's an enigma in itself, but yeah, getting that match and then having to do the build for it and actually getting it, that must just be mind-blowing again for a year in.
Oh man, it was phenomenal. I remember I came to the unit and Scott went to me all the plans for this so-and-so over there, go have a look. I was going through, it was like, I think this was after Anarchy, so I saw Nations, then Inverary plans, then it was Halloween, it was like Ronan King Grado. I was like, oh, no way if I somehow scraped that. And oh, I'm so thankful them for giving me that, because that match is probably still, even though it's technically not the best wrestling match, of course not, it is one of, it's probably my favorite match I've had. It was so much fun. Grado was so good to work with, and he just felt really good in that ring. Like, the vibe was so good.
It was just, well, you talked about later on Wrestling Daft, I think the week after, and he was picking you up and all that kind of stuff, other than him getting his speeding conviction on the way up the road. But yeah, there's not many people in WrestleZone that can say they've worked Grado. I mean, one other guy in their first year that did that was Vago, funnily enough. But yeah, it's not a lot of people that say they could do that. And some of your experience, again, put into that position is just amazing as well. Tremendous, as Vago would say. One thing he did do, which blew Kyle's mind at the show, which unfortunately it didn't blow mine just as much because I saw you do it the week before at Trinity Center.
That was an accident.
was the flip over the rope 450, land on your feet. So I was the one at Trinity Center, an accident then.
Yeah. I was just gonna flip dive, and then when I landed, I was like, oh, come to my feet, sick. Because me and Corey Malloy, we had like a really good, like, obviously I live in Glasgow now, if you didn't know, but get into that later. But they were like, that summer we were in training so much together. And we were just constantly trying out these mental flips. Just like, what can we actually push ourselves to do? And I think we just accidentally, I think I hit it first. Like, I just kind of did it. And then I kind of my feet, I was like, that was sick that he did it. He can also do it, spoiler alert. But we were like, that's sick. And I was like, all right, cool. That's one for Grado. I'll work that in. But the training center match, I was just like, okay, I'll do a flip dive. And then by the time I was there, I was like, oh, I'm coming to my feet now. Cool. Sweet.
I thought it was more a case of you saw the floor because it wasn't padded. It's like the last thing you wanted. I saw Dynamite do the through the rope suicide and just like stop himself just before going any further rotation, because it was like, that is not a floor you want to land on. There's wood,
no,
but not, what is it? A tile. Oh, no, thank you.
I did it this weekend. I was down at New Wave. And I'm impressed Flash Morgan Webster with the fact I could do it. So, you know, it's a win now. It's a win.
it's incredible. It's just one of those, like you say, you're just trying it. It was just, yeah, one of those things where you think, ah, I could probably do it if I wanted to.
If I tried. Yeah. It was about this, like, oh, like I'm getting a lot of rotation on this. Probably just go for it. But
So after that match with Grado, that was just seemed to be from that point onwards, you're everywhere. Just about.
oh yeah.
You end up in Fair City, end up in Wrestle Carnival not long afterwards as well. But so Wrestle Carnival, how did that come about?
I love Wrestle Carnival so much. So I started training with Joe at this point. Sorry. And Joe was really good at, obviously, he works with a lot of promoters. So he was bringing them up to a school and he was like, right, have showcase matches. So I wrestled Zero, and then I wrestled Connor and impressed Gary the Booker enough that he was like, yeah, cool. I want to bring you down. And I was originally meant to be in the, sorry, in the Future Cup. But he wanted to bring down Judas as well again. And Big Chairs and Monstrum could drive us down. So he's like, sick, that's going to be a fun triple threat. And oh my God, it was the most indie-rific match ever. It was so much fun. So much fun.
Is it one of the case for that kind of promotion where you don't have to work as family friendly? As in, when you're up here at WrestleZone, it's more hand clapping, you get the reaction, you don't really have to, the wrestling isn't as important as the character. Whereas Wrestle Carnival, I suppose it's a bit more on the work, the actual wrestling, than it is the character.
It was a lot more. Like, I remember I did, God, the travel was horrendous. So we did Station Hotel the night before. I wrestled Archer, and then I did the tag team title match against the Saints. Then I had to drive straight up from that show. I crashed at Emersyn and Aspen's. Then me and Emersyn wake up at like 4 a.m., bus over to Edinburgh, meet Judas and Monstrum, then like 7 hour drive. It was brutal, brutal, but so worth it. And by the time we got there, we're all sitting in the car throwing around the ideas. We're like, right, this is going to be stupid fun. Stupid fun. And it was great.
That night was actually like for the Aberdeen portion of it, you were the star of that show. Again,
Three
sorry,
times,
I'm
three
sorry for people
times.
that are going to hear me just load
Thank
all the
you.
praise onto Ronan. But yeah, so you did the pre-show, and then you appeared and then of course the big setup angle for Aberdeen Anarchy was laid on that show as well. So you're all over it, and I think I put out a tweet afterwards, possibly saying that you pretty much any time you came out, you just stole it, stole the show anyway.
That was so much fun. That was such a great weekend for me. That was one of my favorite weekends, if not my favorite, in wrestling so far.
And we're saying all this like you're not even you're just about hit the 2 year mark, and you've got all these kind of big moments and that already in that time. It's just, yeah, mind blowing. Right, so
I'm just so grateful for like everyone that takes a chance. It's like I could be more grateful to everyone and every promotion that gives me a shot. Like, it's been class.
I think it's because you really when you're on the show, that's who you are. You're Ronan King, absolute bells and whistles. But I'm not, I wouldn't reveal the messages, but whenever DMs go back and forth, you're just like the coolest guy. At the same time, very
Thank you very
respectful, very
much.
humble. And then when the bell rings or when you go to a show, everyone believes you're an absolute prick. So it's quite incredible how to balance that again so early on, because some people can find that a little difficult to, right? Oh, don't want to be thought of as a bad guy, 100% bad guy. Oh, but because you're so entertaining with it, you'll still have kids coming up to you after the show wanting a picture or that, and it's like you're an absolute prick again, but just to the wrestlers. So you never really go out your way to, well, except call my child ugly, but you never really go out your way to mock the fans. It's always directed straight to the wrestler, going, "I am better than you. I am the." It's almost like MGF-ish kind of way, I suppose.
I would be lying if I didn't draw a lot of inspiration from him. He's phenomenal, so.
So yeah, so Fair City Wrestling, of course, I think it was a triple threat. You and No, it was, or is it just you versus Connor?
There's me, Connor, and Ian Ambrose. There's
Ian
your
Ambrose.
third. Yeah.
So it's starting to make your way around the country as well, and let's say Wrestle Carnival, quite a big, even though they're quite early on, they've got quite a big buzz about them because the boy that runs it, Gary, he's got quite a he seems to have quite a he's got a looking sharp size black book of contacts. It seems he's got quite a lot of guys coming through there, like from Ring of Honor
That's great.
and that, and he seems to
Yeah,
put.
he's got them all the contacts in the world at that.
He seems to put a lot of weight into that kind of pure style. Is that a style that you're, is that a style that you like to do, or are you just more liking having the shackles off, maybe the chains off a little bit, and being able to do more kind of athletic flips and all that kind of
Yeah.
stuff down there?
So I think pure is something I'm progressively getting way better at. Like, pure is something I'm not comfortable with, but I'd love to do it. You know what I mean? It's not my favorite style because I feel like me and my character works way more with free flowing and being able to do what I do. Like, I'm never going to be a Chris Ridgeway, but I'd like to be able to do that sort of thing. So, you know, if Gary, let's say, messaged me tomorrow, I was like, oh, I want Pete in a pure match, I'd be comfortable in it. I'd feel ready to do it. So, I do want to do more pure, yeah, but it's not my favorite style.
Enough, and we've got someone like an Emerson who's quite adept at that, and I suppose Aspen as well. He enjoys that kind of style. So you've kind of again surrounded yourself with people that are, like, able to teach you, or at least give you some sort of nuggets of information towards any
Yeah.
just about any style that you kind of want to put your hand to as well.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I feel like with all the people I've got, like, the boys at WrestleZone, like the boys at Joe's and everything, all the schools I train at, it's like I'm really got a good balance of everything that can bring it together. Like, if I train with CPW, it's all the character work that I really get out of it. If it's like Joe's, I get a lot of tech, a lot of really cool maneuvers and things. The wrestling's everything. Like, again, you get bits of everything from everywhere. It's so good. So.
So was the move to Glasgow wrestling based, or was it just life based? Because I mean you're 20, so I assume education somewhere in there as well, and you've kind of got the youth to be able to do just about anything you want to do, go anywhere you want to go. Was it all wrestling based, or was it just
It was a
circumstance?
very, it was circumstantial, but a big driving factor to just go with the circumstance was wrestling based. So my best mate from school, he bought a flat and he was like, Luke, do you wanna move in? So me and my girlfriend moved in and now we're up here. And for me it was very like, I've got a free bus pass right now, so I can get wherever I want in the country. So I can still go up and down to WrestleZone. So like, I'm going on Wednesday, I'm going down again. Then I've got Joe's like half an hour away from mine right now. And I've got this, like Community Pro half an hour. Girders is 15 minutes away. Like I'm really pretty much in the center of everything. And it makes it way easier for like a booker to be like, oh, he's in Glasgow. There's probably a Glasgow card going anyway. Let's chuck him in that. So it wasn't originally wrestling based, but because of wrestling, it's become a great decision, I think.
And it seems to have picked up because of that, like you say, because it is central, and there's probably someone's going to go, and having that, I don't know, I would say free travel. I've got away another. Oh, it's getting slower. It's getting closer and closer to get a free bus pass on my end. Yeah, so it's yeah, that's still a lot of travel though. So how do you kind of spend your time with that travel? If it's just on your own up to Aberdeen, or is it podcasts? Just thinking of ideas
Yeah.
for watching wrestling, try and note something that you want to try. What's your kind of, how do you fill your time?
It's different every time. Sometimes I'm a little bit like, well, you know what? If I was at home, I probably wouldn't be doing anything. So I might as well do nothing on a bus and get something more out of it. But like, I watch a lot of wrestling. That's where I catch up on it. Like, again, notes apps, Instagram posts, like scheduling stuff. What do I do on those buses? I don't even know. I don't mind the bus at all. Like, I actually turned 20 on a bus back from Aberdeen, so it's not a bad vibe. Sleep. I sleep so much on buses. I'm lucky. I can just go like that. I'm up. So I don't mind travel at all. Like, especially when it's good lads. Like, oh, it's easy.
We've definitely got some questions about traveling. I think all your travel buddies from how old did I send there? Your travel buddies, that from New Wave were throwing in some questions towards the end,
Oh,
and
no.
we'll get into those in a bit. But we'll round off a little bit of your wrestling journey, and we'll go into the questions. I will miss out a load of stuff because you have, like I say,
That's fine.
you've done loads during that time. But if there's anything that I've specifically missed, just throw it in somewhere, and
Oh, pleasure.
we'll get in. We'll just go straight to Abu Dhabi because we talked about Summer Hill Showdown. Sorry, Station Hotel Showdown. It would have been at the start of the year, and you had those three segments, three moments. And then to Abu Dhabi, which is a match probably isn't high on your favorite list of actual matches itself, because I think Damien let me know that he got banged up really badly at the start of the match, and then you had to kind of take over the match, and then you stabbed him. So it came down to the match itself. There was a lot coming into it, but did it live up to your expectation? And how did it feel having to maybe take more responsibility than you were initially thinking you would have had to take?
So, like, they lived up to my expectation, no. Like, we had a really good match planned, and I hope to one day actually be able to run the match we had. But I am grateful for the experience. Obviously, I'm not grateful for the situation. Like, Damien got, like, I'm talking like a minute in, he got caught with one of my forearms. So it was like weird. It was a lack of like working together. He ticked forearms differently, and I kind of panicked and just threw it. So he gets banged. I didn't realize he was hurt. Like, I can't remember what the next spot is, but he pulls me up in the corner, and I think he's just forgotten. So for ages, I'm really trying to call this whole match. Like, for God's sake, I called the man to dive on me. This man can't see straight, and he's diving on me. And then it wasn't until the spot was double clothesline, no one goes down. I went for the clothesline, he ducked, it came under me. I backheld him like out of instinct, and he just dropped and rolled out of the ring. And I was like, oh no, something's gone wrong. So I was being told, look, he's hurt. Let's go to a finish. And respect to him, he wanted to do the whole match. He really wanted to get it done, and it would have been great, but we got what we got. And I think actually, I hated the match at the start. But having watched it back, I'm a little bit like, you know what? The story is very different, but it's kind of interesting because I look like a piece of shit. There's this man that's clearly out of it, and I'm beating the fuck out of him. There's a moment early on when he's like out of it, but I didn't know. And he like drops down to a knee, and I'm like, that's not the spot. Here's a boot in the face. And I just boot him in the face. I'm like, I would never have done that if I knew he wasn't there. And then we had the infamous shooting star.
I was going to mention the shooting star.
Never missed it in training. I never missed it in training. Like, it looks looking picture perfect before the show. And it was just going up, and I see Damien giving me the look of like, oh my God, he has no idea what I'm going to do to him here. And you can see it in the watch back. I had a little stutter because I'm like, oh God, should I go? And then I just try to send it, and I'm lucky to be alive.
It's the whole it was the it's literally the start of Brock Lesnar WrestleMania 19. It's the exact same, just a little hesitation that just, oh man. But like you're saying, I think I've got the kind of same opinion as someone who watched it. Like, I didn't like it at first, I didn't enjoy it at first, and then the more I thought about it, I was like, but it was uncomfortable, and that's probably the best outcome that you could have had in that situation, was people literally thought you were a piece of shit because they're watching you batter someone who is not all there. And thankfully, Damien's safe. I mean, he had one eye for a bit, but other than that, it was deeply uncomfortable. And it was hilarious though, because not the match itself, because it, like I say, it was awkward and uncomfortable. But then the next thing was Mr. WrestleZone and Omar and all that kind of stuff. And I think I put it on the podcast, but if anyone didn't listen to the road trip, it was just Kelly just going, that was too far. That was difficult. That was really uncomfortable to watch. It was so horrible to watch. And then New Sensation comes on. She goes, "New Sensation." This is wrestling. I think that's wrestling summed up quite nicely in that moment.
Omar brings such a good vibe. Like, Omar is fantastic. And you know what? There's no man that could make like the fans forget. I've just stabbed the guy's eye up. And we're all walking backstage, like, stuttering. Like, poor David's daughter, I remember rolling up, being like, right, let me try and get some heat. As if I didn't have enough already. And I go to look at her, to jeer at her, and she's just streaming with tears. I'm like, right, I'm not going to know anyone. I'll be leaving now. But, again, the only guy that could pick up after that is Omar. Like, what a great babyface, man.
Absolutely. And that whole thing with Mr. WrestleZone, who we do not know who he is, of course. The whole madness of it. I kind of blow hot and cold more recently with it, but it's still it's like there's the Bulgarian Baker in W3L, who for years, every time I see him, I'm like, maybe I've grown out of Bulgarian Baker. Maybe I won't find this funny. And then he comes out, and I think this is the best thing ever. I'm kind of that with Mr. WrestleZone, going, no, I think I'm growing out of Mr. WrestleZone. I think maybe this is getting too silly now. And he comes out and like, no, this is still the funniest thing I've ever seen. It's great. That's it.
But again, whoever he is, he's fantastic.
Absolutely,
it's incredible. So good.
We're talking about. We'll stick on Armory Anarchy for a moment because I think this was your first merch. That came out, and people bought it. For whatever reason, it was a white T-shirt. Just the poster with your face on it. I think I may have put in the review that, you know, I loved that they didn't look great, but people were still buying them because they still find you so entertaining. I think that's power. That's a terrifying power you may have, that you can put out merch that doesn't look great and they're like, yeah, I'm still buying it anyway because I like Ronan King, even though he's about to stab someone.
I was grateful people bought it because I remember getting these people like, oh no. Oh no. And then I remember selling a lot and I was like, okay, I'm a happy man now. It's fine. I'll take that hit.
I mean, there's still, like, there's still great T-shirts, but like, they were so, like, it was just like they don't look great in comparison to everyone's nice bear hug design T-shirts, and people are still buying them anyway, which, you know, money in your pocket.
Well, yeah, we could see a Ronan King bear hug soon. We'll see.
Spoilers, teasing. So to kind of round up a little bit, then, what was that? That was your Jeff Jarrett gear as well, Armory Anarchy.
Oh yeah,
it broke. Like 5 minutes. Wasn't a great night for you, was it?
No, me and my girlfriend made that. It took us so. I made it. No, I literally stood there. She went around me making it. It took us so long to make, and it instantly came off. We're like, well, fuck. And I tried to wrestle with it for a little while, and we figured out how to make it stay on. But yeah, just I haven't brought it back since. So.
It's a shame because it's not as a big year, right? We're going to look to happier things because, you know, I'm not going to labor too much on probably not one of the highlights of your night, of your short career so far.
Well, you know what? There was a great photo of me, Damien, and Dawkins on the hospital after. Because obviously everyone else went out for drinks after the show. This photo's all just like this in the hospital.
Because Dawkins broke his arm, broke his wrist, didn't he?
Yeah. So I went first after my neck, and they're like, right, go. Then Damien pulled up maybe like 3 minutes later, and he's completely out of it. And then I think I get pulled in, and I get like a little bit assessed. Oh, they asked me to take off my kick pads and boots. It was the worst. Like, it took me like a good 10 minutes to take them off. And then Doc is just around the corner. He's like, sup? And I'm like, what the fuck happened to you now? It was so cursed. But I'm happy there's at least three of us. It was a nice vibe, at least in the hospital, no matter how bleak it was.
Danston, I mean, by the time this episode comes out, we would have been at Christmas Chaos. You may or may not be WrestleZone Tri-Counties champion. It seems to be quite a cursed venue, though, for WrestleZone. I don't think recently there's been a show where everyone's came out in one piece. It's usually Damien that's injured at the shows, but I don't think...
let's just take him off the shows.
I know.
To
be honest, I'm more worried that if he's got that reputation of getting injured at these shows, and he's got Captain Allen. I'm like, how would you get injured against Captain Allen? I'm actually more intrigued about that than the
You'll find a way. Watch.
So for transparency again, yes, it'll be after Christmas Chaos, and also it'll be after Governversary. So we'll speak a little bit about ladder match because we'll be one of your first ones. So we could be speaking about all the cool things that you want to do in a ladder match, and none or all may have happened by the time this episode actually goes out itself. But yeah, let's go into Community Pro, because it seems to be a promotion, like say it's very close to you anyway, now that you're located in Glasgow. And you seem to be, again, properly making an impression there. With you had your little back and forth with the Wanderer, and now you're into the Governversary ladder match. And these Ravy Davies done something incredible for his promotion anyway. It's loud shows, loud crowds. What's it like getting involved with Community Pro?
Oh, I'm so grateful for David. David's such a good guy, and he treats me so well. And it was one of those where I met him first at Joe's. Me and Connor had a little match in front of him, and he was like, cool, I want to book yous. However, at this point, he was filled up. He's like, right, April, we'll put you two in a team against Termination Z. Again, it's a lot of fun. It's an indie match. And then after it, I remember just talking to him. He was like, oh, you know, if you lived closer, was basically the thing. And he asked me a couple of times. So he asked me when the foundation lads were going down. He's like, hey, are you free? Do you want to hop in the car with them? And I was like, yeah, I'd love to. And he asked me for the show Caleb was on. But I was flying back from Germany. And we were really trying to make it work. It's like, could I get there in time? But no, there was no chance. So didn't get that, but... Again, he's been, and then I moved, and he's been so grateful. He stayed to his word. He always asks if I want to work with him. So he's such a good guy. The shows he runs are so, such a good vibe. I hate using that phrase. I keep using it, but it's such a good vibe. It's, all the guys are great. It's all good fun. The crowds he draws are rabid, which is great for me. So much fun. So
that's it. Yeah,
can't be more grateful for him.
That's it. Because I went to one community show, and it was the Peterhead one. And I've obviously been to a lot of wrestling in the Northeast for a number of years now, and I don't know what it is about Ravy Davies crowds, but they were just, like you're saying, rabid. They were scarily rabid. I'm like, I hope to never see you again, kids, because you all scare me a little bit. So,
if I go to a wrestling show and I'm like I'm coming around and call the kids all like stupid, it's like they're good, that they give me chat back. I don't have the fear of being attacked. At Davies, I can just walk around and then, oh, there's an inflatable hammer. Great, right, let me sell this now.
Oh, I hate inflatable hammers. I still hate them to this day, but it's quite a vision to watch a bad guy getting leathered with an inflatable hammer. I'm not, especially the ones up here. I don't know if Davies' crowd have worked out if they turn that. Oh, no, they have, because they stopped putting out hammers that have claw sides. Which is a fantastic idea, because I have seen the case where I've watched kids smack bad guys, I think probably Ski Bali or something, with the claw end of a playable hammer, which looks like it would still hurt, regardless of it being playable.
There's a great moment where Ryan Riley, he's in the street fight, and Davey's got him like arms behind his back. He's going around the crowd doing the chop spot, and a fan just comes up and just absolutely uppercuts him in the balls, and he's like trying not to laugh, and he turns around and all these like there's like 20 kids just battering with hammers. I was like, this poor guy's just been uppercutting in the balls, and he's just getting like absolutely whacked by that. It's phenomenal.
Oh, that's the least he can get for saying he was sleeping really well after the birth of his daughter. Sorry, daughter. Oh, I've blanked there, and I feel really bad about it because I really like Ryan. elsewhere, and then we'll move into, because we've got loads of questions. Facing Emersyn Jayne at Fair City Wrestling. That's probably quite at that point must be one of your kind of matches you wanted to tick off as soon as you possibly could, and It was on FCW Empire because I watched it, and it was excellent. It had this like kind of course, you're cocky Ronan King, bit misogynist in that respect because you're facing a woman, even though it's Emersyn Jayne, who's probably one of the best wrestlers in the country. But that must have just been quite a thrill to actually get into the ring with someone who has helped elevate you as a wrestler.
Yeah, like me and Emerson, I always put her over, you know, she stopped, but she's phenomenal. She's been so good to me ever since we met. And like, especially since I moved down here, like, we'll just, if we both have a free day, we'll just head to a ring and we'll just try things out. And she's so good. So when I heard about that match, it's like, oh, this is going to be so much fun. I remember that I was training together for it. She's so great. And she like totally like took my ideas on board. And obviously, she let me do the Adam Cole ball spot, which respect for her for being like, yeah, that's fine, I'll take it. So, again, I love that match. I think it was so much fun. Misogyny, again, I was very happy. She was like, you need to be misogynistic. I was like, I can do that. I get heat for that. There is, though, a shocking moment at the start of the match where, like, I tell her to, like, make me a sandwich or something, and a guy in the front row with his daughter and wife sit there and goes, let's go, Ronan, come on. And he's like cheering me on. I'm like, mate, it's a bit, come on.
No, this is not the bit you're supposed to cheer.
Yeah.
Oh man. I've never heard something so wrestling fan though. That's something you can just go, yeah, that happens at a wrestling show. That definitely is a thing, unfortunately. Right. We can't really speak about Christmas Chaos. We can't speak about Governversary. Actually, we'll speak a little bit of Governversary because you got a ladder match. Is there loads of ideas already? Have you already brainstormed with Judas Grey, as he already told you no?
What do you think he wants to do? What do you think he wants to do, Billy?
Jump off all the things, through all the things.
Yeah, we have. It was instantly, I remember Davey telling me it, and he was the first guy I said, he was like, look, Davey's told me there's a ladder match. Check if you're in it. And Davey told him he had it. He was like, great. And we're just like, right. This spot, I won't spoil them because we're going to talk over them tonight and see. But if we can work all our spots, it's going to be pretty mental for sure. I'm excited about it.
So we'll move on to the questions. Like I say, we got loads, and then we'll finish off our other bits and pieces. We'll go to Instagram first, just do the public ones, go to Twitter, and then we'll finish with the ones that were sent to me privately. Ashley Vega just asking, favorite WWE diva?
That's a tough question because I only watched wrestling with the Divas era for 4 months before getting the women's. So if we're going classic and not women's wrestling, she was still a diva. Becky Lynch. Becky Lynch is so good. Like, everything she does is great. So yeah, Becky Lynch, easily. But
it's your GTA 5 photo over again when you've just told me that you only watched Divas for 4 months and became women's again. Oh man, that hurt me.
I was nine when GTA 5 came up. The second I saw that trend going by, I was like, oh, I'm going to ruin some people's day.
I know, and I'm only in my early 30s. I feel sorry for guys like Scotty and Blue Thunder and Johnny Lyons, who's 100. Oh, yeah. You know, so I've got Tom Atlas asking, why'd you stab Damien, dude? Like, come on, bro.
Deserved it. I get it. Fuck that guy. No, again, I think it was good because for me, getting to bring this intensity side out of the character is a lot of fun. Like, obviously, I'm very out there in the ring, but being able to show that I can just be just as vicious as much as I can fucking wiggle my hips is really fun. So I enjoyed it. Sorry, David. I enjoyed it.
Was there any point you were thinking maybe just to pull it back a little bit, was the old Hot Fuzz tomato packet and just like make it red? Why not? Go whole hog and just blood
everywhere. Maybe I should blade a little bit for you. There was enough. I think I was bleeding after that match, but just from grabbing the glass, like, caused me to cut open. But
So the two of you, you're the only one that actually got busted by risk taker. We've got Kirsten Louise, got a couple questions through here. When are you going to actually win that belt? I mean, you could be champion by the time this comes out, I suppose.
I basically am champion. You know, he got disqualified, I won. I should be champion. And Yeah, if it takes me beating him again at Christmas without cheating, I'll do it.
Okay, so again,
Happily.
this could be a case where if I'm smart enough to edit in, could have a picture of you with the title
It
or
will.
part of a montage. I'm noticing that my glasses are steaming up, so I apologize for anyone who's watching this and having to witness that happen. Right, so we've got Kirsten Louise also asking, favorite match of 2023 while I clean my glasses.
Oh, so my four-way at Disco, me, Omar, Rob Mills, and Alex Webb, I really enjoyed. That's up there for me. Me, Caleb, is really up there. The Carnival Triple Threat start of the year is really up there. Me, Zach, and Webb had another Triple Threat Disco like a couple weeks ago. That was again so much fun. Me, Judas at Disco, me and Sam, Emerson, Jayne. There's too many. It take me a while to sit down and be like, yeah, this is my favorite one this year.
I
It's
feel
good.
so bad for my note taking that I didn't even write down disco. That is absolutely shocking. I forgot
I'm a
about
bit of over
disco.
it. Disco's phenomenal. I love disco so much. Like, disco is great, and I'm so thankful for Alan for it. He's seen me wrestle at Joe's again a few times. So he was like, are you free? I want to do you, Judas. I was like, oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm free.
And it's one of the probably one of the best promotions in the country, as a
Oh,
probably as a variety anyway, certainly has the character and the actual wrestling work at the same time. Yeah, so it must be
agreed.
great to actually get involved with that and actually be there quite a bit with Judas, or you were the valet for time traveling Sammy Jayne. Even
So I'll
though
start here.
I know that actually terrified me, because when she was Sammy Jayne, right at Princess Sammy, that was what's 2012, that was 2012, 2013. So that
So
was
I was
ten.
eight or nine. Eight or nine, yeah.
And now you've got to deal with Emerson and Sammy Jayne in one go. That was
Yeah.
very, very aging for me. You know what? I don't know why I ask you back on, Ronan, because you make me feel old, and you don't even mean to.
No, I need to. I need to.
So we'll go on to Twitter. There's so many. So
Oh
we'll
God, yeah.
start with fake. We'll start with Omar Muhammad, who you've mentioned is a who's amazing, great baby face. But he's also asked him about his questionable fake tans.
So I wasn't really, I could fake tan in wrestling. My mom had to do it for me for a little while. It's switched now. It's my girlfriend and my flatmate. But I remember my first anarchy, I was like, right, let's layer this on. Let's give me the strongest abs in the world. That's great. I came to the show and like someone made a joke. They're like, oh, hey, Omar. I was like, oh, no. I saw Omar and I think I was darker than him. And I was like, right, this has gone too far. Gone way too far. I've never gone that dark again. But I was like, yeah, sorry, Omar. There's a great photo of us backstage. It's like, we are the same color. If not, I'm more tan than him. So. That was a really questionable day.
Oh dear, so a bit like the Ross Geller effect, just
Yeah, exactly like that.
oh no. You know, I never really noticed on the day. The lighting at the Northern Hotel must have saved you from
It was really like white lighting, so it was okay. I got away with it. But like, if you look at like photos and you see the color I am compared to the color Vago is, it's bad. It's bad.
You could be seen through the white powder that from the guitar.
Yeah.
Judas Gray asked, is it hard being the second best son?
Again, Emerson always says I'm the favorite, so fuck you.
Is Emerson just like building a little like Sons of Emerson kind of?
It started with just it's just me and Judas are the two. Oh, we just kind of like as a trio, we kind of do everything but together. So it's a really good vibe. And then obviously we have other people like extended family, like Omar comes along, like Ashley Vega, everything. Like it's a really good Debbie. Debbie's our drunk uncle. It's a great vibe. We got three dads. We've got obviously Aspen, got Caleb, and we've got all three of the Foundation of Future as one. That's another dad. So yeah. It's a great little family.
That sounds amazing, actually. Sounds great. We've got Kirsten asking, how on earth did you and Judas go from enemies to besties?
There was a moment of realization in Germany where it was like, we hate Omar. We both hate Omar. So it was a moment of realization of, wow, we can actually get on. And now Look at us. We're the boys.
And you beat him in our Halloween hijinks quiz. So,
exactly.
Teamwork. I still feel bad about every day. I still feel bad about seeing Judas look twilighty, and it still makes me blush.
Oh, he's not let go. He's not
as
let
he,
go.
as he not, oh, that's even better. I just, oh, that's like the second most viewed TikTok I've got was putting that out because it's just his face. He looked so offended when I said it. It's great. He's also asked, Judas has, what's it like getting to train with someone as great as him?
I could be a little shit and tell me shit, but yeah, he's out of this world. Good. Like the people I trade with as well, Sam Barber. I put Sam Barber over as well. Like Sam Barber is phenomenal. I'm gonna say Sam Barber a lot to take this away from Judas. You know, Sam Barber is great. Like how he's not everywhere, I won't know. Because he's one of the best wrestlers in this country. He's so marketable, he's got a great look. And he's just so strong in ring and in character. As I say with Judas, you know, I have to put him over. Like the things that kid can do, he's so different than anyone else, and he's phenomenal. Like,
I was actually quite glad that of course I couldn't go to the rescheduled date for Halloween Hijinks, and I was kind of glad that Judas couldn't go, because I was like, that's fine, at least I can hopefully see his debut if he does a future show, and I won't miss it.
I'm trying. Yeah. In my boy.
Well, speaking of that, we've got Carl and Bruce asking, Judas Christmas Chaos, yay or nay? We'll find out by the time this episode goes out, but that's sounding like a nay as far, unless you don't want to.
Hey, I'll try. We'll see. We'll see. I need someone to help me defend my belt. I need a valet girl. He wears a skirt. He's close enough.
Long hair, you know,
Yeah.
yeah, it could work.
Shave the beard, and we could totally get away with it. Put me a little bra and everything.
I mean, he's got the old was it see-through vesty tops. It all works out,
Yeah,
you
it's
know.
all good.
No
It's
judgment
great.
here.
Yeah.
Right. So, where else are we? We've got Colin. We'll go back there. Where's the swear jar? Have you? I mean, you've. I haven't heard any incidents recently.
I've been
Of
really good.
swearing.
No, there's a one and done. There's a one and done. It's okay. I watch myself a lot. I go to it and I'm like, nope. And then I take it back.
I mean, maybe that hesitation, maybe that cost you a match or two if you're trying not to swear at crowds.
Yeah.
And he's also asked, why isn't your intro music something King related instead of, he's put the Shrek song, and that feels like that's really disrespecting to Bonnie Tyler.
It's a Shrek song. That's why I chose it. I love
Oh,
Shrek.
okay, fair enough.
Again, like I use so much different music everywhere. So, I've got my really douchey one, which I use at the start, and then I switched to Hero for Anarchy. I just kept it because I think it's a great song and it's a great vibe. And then at CPW, I use Pony, the Magic Mike song. That's another great song. That's phenomenal. So, King related music. Ronan isn't a king. You know what I mean? It's just a name. So, and Shrek 2 is a great film. So, there you go.
Well, I apologize, Callum. I thought that was going to be a silly question, but it is literally the Shrek. It's Shrek is the reason why it's there. It's got a great run up.
Oh, no.
And I think it's even better because it's a kid. Well, it's a kids related film, so kids will be like, "Oh, maybe this is from the film Shrek." And then you come out and you're a dick,
Yeah,
and they go,
fuck this
"Oh
guy.
no, oh no." I've cheered this
Well, I'm one
song.
little fan. I've got two fans. I've got little Mary. I don't know the other kids' names, sadly, but they're my little fans. I love them. Like they wear my T-shirt, and Mary dresses me for Halloween. It was great. Phenomenal.
I love that when it happens. Like last year, there was a kid dressed as Mr. P. I know,
Yeah.
that was the best thing ever. And then they won the Halloween costume in the contest, and I was sitting there raging, dressed as Bagel.
I beat him. He's not cool anymore.
Fair enough, but fair enough. So we've got Kwaku asking, who's the best 19-year-old wrestler now?
Oh, this is quite a tough one. So, like, obviously, there's a bunch. I could say, Darren Blair, great guy,
You're only
good in
19.
ring.
Oh, God.
Yeah, he's only 19. I think he's a couple months younger than me. The other 19-year-olds have all just turned 20. Like Robbie Cardwell is another one, but he's just turned 20. But you could say Leon Slater. Leon Slater is only 19 or maybe just turned 20, but I think the essence of me will always be the best 19-year-old wrestler in the world. So me is the answer.
Fair enough.
Because I'm better than Leon Slater.
Speaking of Leon Slater, I suppose that goes nicely into gut check. You competed
Yeah.
in the Impact Wrestling. I'm really worried you saying Impact Wrestling because I just want to say TNA gut check.
January.
That must have been an experience in itself. I mean, you'll know Joe,
Yeah.
of course, from training with him and training under him. But that whole day, was that just madness?
It was a really good vibe. Like, I hate saying that, but I say it so much. But like, it's like all these wrestlers I haven't met, or I'd like met a few, and like seeing Renzo Rose from OTT, I wrestled him at CPW, seeing him again. Like, great guy, all the talent in the world. He will go far. CJ West, like being all these new people I hadn't met, but like it was like almost like most of the Scottish scene all coming together. So it was a really nice experience. So yeah, I enjoyed it.
I think the Renzo Rose though, he needs to shave those sideburns. They are incredible. It's just
They
jealousy.
work for him.
It's
They
just
work for
jealousy.
him.
If I have the sideburns like him, I just look terrible because I'm bald.
I think you should do it for Christmas, Billy. Just.
No, I was gonna go for the I just get this bit down the middle gone and just go for the Lemmy,
Oh,
Triple H 2003 kind of look.
yeah.
That's the look to go for. I think I'd live my own after that. I don't think Kelly could look at me until it's gone back to
Okay.
there was.
You've got to live alone for like a month and then it'll be back. See, it'll be fine.
Yeah, that's fine. So what else have we got? Colin Ward asked your questions. That's fine. Grapsilla Mayhem Brooks asked, how good is your takedown defense?
I could school. I could school. No, again, Grabzilla. Like, I don't want to be like the guy that's pretty everyone over, but he's phenomenal. And he lives up in Elgin, so he lives near you, I think. So it's
He
like
does.
how he's not being around more is nuts. Like, he's phenomenal. I properly met him for the first time ever at Attitude when we were in that match. And again, he's just, great wrestler, better person. You know what I mean? Like, great guy. So again, it's just a shame where he lives because he could be all over it. Like,
I know,
he's the
Elgin's a bit of a
closest
shithole.
shoot fight we have in this country. What?
Elgin's a shithole.
Yeah. You get like W3L like, once every couple months.
that's a bit, but it's great to see him evolve as well. He kind of had the opposite. He started with the cocky character, and I think he's realized that Elgin anyway, you don't need to be. You just need to be Elgin boy, and people will love you anyway. So just go for that. But yeah, it's good to see him doing well, and of course he won the breakout title recently here as well. So it's all good. Right. Westy's question, I think that's a good closer. So we'll move on to the other Instagram ones, which possibly may go well and may not. We've got Zachary Swift asking, is Ronan
Oh,
quite a trendy guy?
I'm very trendy, Zach. He knows this. He again. I'm gonna do it again.
Vibe.
Again, I only met for the first time on Friday, where we went down to New Wave again. Another such a good guy, a real drive to be better, improve himself, and new experiences, which I respect so much. I think he'll do well for himself. Like, head screwed on, good guy, really like pushing himself, which is great.
He's got
Great
to keep
to see.
the family name Swift going as well since
Yeah,
Scotty
exactly.
retired.
I mean, he's like, he's Zach and Scott's Swift. He's Zach and Scott's kids, so I've got good hopes for him.
Rob Stowe, I don't know if this is quite related, but he just put Tren.
Oh yeah, okay, yeah, Trent, yeah, Trent.
Is this
I
another
don't know how
young?
to
I
explain it.
was gonna say, is this another young Potter word that I'm never gonna understand?
Do you know what Trent is? Okay, it's like steroids. So,
Okay, right. That explains a question I got through that NGL thing recently. That's fine. Okay. Good, good,
hey, I
good.
don't know if we were just like talking through gimmick ideas in the car, so I'm gonna start something, hopefully. So, you heard it here first, but we're gonna do trend spotting. Is that trend spotting? I'm just gonna go and like interview wrestlers. I just go, yeah, trend or not, you know what I mean? So that's just a bit, just a bit.
That's fine. That explains a really confusing question. Well, not confusing question that I got through that NGL, which was, do you know many that are on Tren,
Oh,
steroids, and all that kind of stuff. I was like, I could probably pick a couple, but I don't. Anyway, I'm not going to do that on here.
Yeah, don't call people out for it.
No,
But
no. But you know who you are. Right.
Well, right now, I've got no tread. I better say that. I've got no tread as of yet.
You're natty. You're all
I am
natural.
currently natty. Yeah.
Rob Stowe's also asked, how do you feel about emus?
Piece of shit. I'm terrified of emus. I hate them. They just really creep me out. I went to a petting zoo and I saw one and I was like, no, I hate them. It kept staring at me and I've never been so scared. Fuck emus. Maybe that's my first merch.
That's just, yeah, fuck emus. Doesn't need
Yeah.
no other explanation. Amazing. Again, thank you for that, because we're having a conversation this weekend about emus, the puppet, and
Oh, yeah.
Kelly kept saying Keith and emu. I was like, that's not right, but I don't know enough to correct her. I've just remembered it's Rod Hull, so I've just texted her that.
Oh, yeah, you
That's the only thing I've texted her. No context. I'm hoping she knows what I
yeah.
mean. Just Rod Hull. Right. So we've got Colton Davis. How does it feel to be the second best 20-year-old wrestler in the world?
Fuck that piece of shit. No, I wouldn't know. Only he knows. So
Oh, there we go.
again, call it though, great guy. I just keep saying that was just great guy, great in ring, lovely guy. Like, again, book him, please.
Bit damage control before you tell him to go fuck himself.
Yeah, fuck you, Colin.
Ian Skinner asking, steel cube or pillow?
Still, well, you wouldn't be a pillow in the ring, but when you walk out and stuff, I'd say, or presence around steel cube.
Fair enough. That's fine. I like that. I didn't know what that meant until you've kind of explained it there. That makes sense.
It was something Flash said when he was trying to like
Ah.
teach a trainee for rolls. He's like, you want to be like a pillow, you want to be round, you can't roll a steel cube. And it was just the most random thing we all heard, and we're like, what the fuck? But yeah.
Sam Barber, who we've mentioned, he's the only wrestler I think I've defended against kids. That's quite a weird claim that I've got. If anyone's watched, go watch the CPW episode of the road trip if anyone else wants to
Yeah.
know about that. So he's
Protect
put
him at all costs.
I've protected him against CPW kids. That's
Hero of the people.
he's asked, you've got a 3-hour journey to a show, fill your car, one driver and four passengers.
Oh, jeez. Oh, man. No, that's gonna better get heat for this. Oh. Oh, right. Oh, no. Oh. I had a great car journey with Sam recently, so we'll slide him in. I can't answer, Billy. There's too many people I want in my car. Can I get a bus instead?
No. As far as drivers, though, is there anyone that you've been in with went, I'd rather not, maybe not you being the driver? They can be a
Omar
passenger instead.
Mohammed. Omar Mohammed. No. That's so like I'm trying to go through drivers. It's like I love a car, I have a Connor. I love one with Omar. I love one with Chez. I love one with Zach Swift. It's too many good drivers. Caleb as well. Like, me and Caleb did a 14-hour drive in one day to Carnival and back. Oops. I'm happy at him. It was me, him, Sammy, Emerson, and Layton. Great car. Like, again, really good fight. So. That's not my answer. Oh.
That's a good
We'll put a few
mix.
people in.
That's
Yeah,
a
there's
good
the.
mix.
I also want Judas. I want all the boys. Just everyone. All three foundation on the boot. We'll put Aspen as like a pirate ship, but the other person at the front. That could be Aspen. Put Rob. We'll put Skinner. We'll put everyone in. We'll fit. It's like a clown car. We'll fit everyone in. Everyone can come in the car.
We'll find a way. So we've got one question left from Westy. I think we'll kind of round that one off as the last question. I forgot to, also didn't write down that you are an award winner.
I am.
You are an SWN award winner. Totally
It's still
legitimate
madness.
vote.
Yeah.
Must be quite good that in that time that you've at least got enough. You've made enough of an impression that people have voted for you. It's a
Yeah.
totally legitimate award that I did not vote in myself. But people actually took the time out of the day to go, yeah, I need to give Ronan King
That was great. I know like the whole book jokes about the war, but it was really good like to see that. And you know, it was better that Judas was too. That was one. So yeah. No, I get it. It was great. I'm very grateful for that. And you know, it helped me swore my girlfriend. So for winning.
That's it. So just go up and go, did you know that this tiny
I think we
trophy
were on a date at the time and I was like, oh, guess who's number one to watch?
thing? Oh, that's I hope that's true. And So last question from Westgate, and then we'll do some other bits and pieces because I'm realizing that but Martin McAllister waiting in the wings soon to speak to him
Oh,
for next week's episode. Is there any big names in the Scottish wrestling scene or in the USA who you'd most like to face next in 2024?
God. Oh, God, there's too many. Like, if we're cutting it down to Scottish scene, I'm going to yes later. We'll do love to wrestle Skinner. Like, Skinner, great again, great guy, great ring. Like, so Skinner, again, Raw. Monster. There's too many. I just want to wrestle everyone. Like, there's too many. Like, I'll put WrestleZone. I'd love to wrestle Omar. Love to wrestle Connor on an actual show. I'd love to all Foundation Boys. Like, there's people I'm forgetting. There's easily people I'm forgetting that I'm like, yeah, I really want like the Gene Money, if you count him when he's at Disco. You know, put me as Gene, Andy, Joe, if he still counts. There's still so many people like Aspen, Jesus, Aspen, you know, let me take that WrestleZone belt off him, please. So, yeah.
Oh man, if I thought him versus Caleb was going to break my heart, I think like throwing the two of you together would also have me in that. But oh my God, I don't know what I want
No,
kind of situation.
I'll win for you, Billy. I'll win for
God,
you.
I think Aspen would hate me if I went for that. There was two more questions from Blue Thunder, which I almost missed, and I think Thunder would have never forgiven me if I did, because they're two really, really great questions. One's a great one to finish with. First one is, how big a part was the WrestleZone Training Academy had it in getting you to the point where you're at just now?
Again, oh my God, I can't credit enough what they do up there. Like, what they do up there is so phenomenal. Everyone's such a good guy. And everyone's so supportive. And again, it's like you are always told how to be better. And it's put me in the position I am today. And like, what they've taught me, I mean, it's the reason I travel, what it takes me at least 7 hours basically of traveling one day to go and train with them. But I still do it because what they're so good at what they do up there. Like, coaches, everyone, it's just phenomenal. You know, Coach Ryan Riley, he'll hate me for saying that. Coach Swift, like everyone, I hate calling him coach, but you know, like Blue Thunder, everyone is so good at what they do. Like Tucker, everyone is just phenomenal. Zach Dynamite, just jumping everyone over. But yeah, it's I couldn't have hoped to start my wrestling career anywhere else. Like, I will always have that place. It's always my home. WrestleZone's always my home, no matter where I go.
And the last question that we'll ask, then we'll do their social medias and whatnot, is what message would you give to anyone out there who wants to give it a go but is still on the fence?
Just do it. Like, just like, what's the worst that can happen? Because wrestling is my life now, and it's what I look forward to every day because of just, you know, being a 15-year-old kid being like, oh, I want to do it, and now look at it. So like, you know, you'll never not have fun, and just, you know, give it a go because you never know where it can take you. It's great.
Fantastic. Excellent. Well, so where can people find out more about Ronan King if they so wish, other than of course buying the merch that'll be coming soon with the tweet on our website. But yeah, so where can people find out more?
So I'm at Ronan underscore King underscore basically everything. So, you know, if you put that into anything, you'll probably find me.
Perfect. Well, great. This has been
Especially only fans.
Whoa, hang on, we're getting some Ronin fans here. We're getting some only Ronin.
That's a great gimmick.
Weird.
Oh my God.
Write that
That's a
down.
great gimmick.
Fine. That's the trade. That's the trade. You can have Ronin fans, and I'll have the t-shirt merch idea. So that's been an absolute blast catching up with you, and I'll see you at Christmas Chaos, and everyone, Brian, I'll get the picture of me with my head in my hands when the near falls are happening between yourself and Caleb, I'm sure. And
I'm really excited.
oh, Oh yeah, I'll be showing all the emotion that I can show on my face, which isn't that many, but there is some there. But no, it's been an absolute blast. Thanks again
Thank
for
you,
having a chat.
man. Hey, it's been a pleasure.